Hi everybody, welcome to a Djembe basics video instruction. This is for anybody who's never played djembe at all, or if you've had very little exposure to technique in djembe. I'm going to give you some pointers on how to get your sounds on the djembe, where to place your hand, and some stuff like that, information like that. So we're going to start with the bass. The bass is a flat hand. It's going to touch all parts of your hand, from the fingertips to the base of the palm. It's the only note that you don't want to use your wrist at all. You're just going to have your arm straight up and straight down in the center of the drum. It's always a quick release. You never want to leave your hand on the drum skin when you're playing the djembe. You need to press and release and come off quickly. So here's a bass note. So you see, I keep my hand straight, I hit the center of the drum, I'm at least a couple inch and a half or 2 inches away from the edge of the drum where the back of my palm connects, and I come off quickly. So the next two sounds are going to be your tones and your slaps. You're going to make a triangle because you're always going to have your index fingers pointing towards each other when you play. This helps create the circle of your arms. It's the positioning of your hand shouldn't be with your elbows in towards your body, and that points your hand straight across the drum. And that's because this is the hardest point of the drum, the wood. And if that comes across your knuckles, that will bruise and hurt. So you always want to have your elbows slightly out, just a relaxed, natural feel. You don't want to exaggerate them. You want your index fingers to point towards each other. Thumbs are always out off of the drum, just kind of up and back. You can see how my thumbs are kind of up and back out of the way. You don't want them down around the drum like that, just kind of up and out of the way. And for the tones and slaps, your wrist is always gonna have a little bit of an angle to it. So my wrist, when I play, is not gonna stay on the same plane as my fingers and my arm like that. That's not how you're gonna get sound out of the djembe. So you want your wrist to be a little bit relaxed so it has a little bit of a bend to it, okay? You're gonna wanna keep your palm engaged so that it doesn't totally collapse when you play the drum like that. So your fingers are never gonna collapse into your hand. So you have to kind of engage the muscles in your palm to keep your palm open, but don't stress your fingers. So your fingers are gonna stay either together or relaxed. So together for the tone, relaxed for the slap. Tone is together, slap is relaxed. But the palm always is gonna stay slightly open. You can have a little natural curve to it, like that if you want, but not like that, okay? So tone, fingers are together. You're gonna use your elbow to lift and release your arm and snap it back as soon as you touch the drum. There are two sweet spots where you line your hand up on your djembe. If you have short fingers, like me, or if you have a large djembe, you can play just under the knuckles, right there. That's where you'll line up the top part of the wood of the djembe. If you have long fingers or a very small diameter djembe, you're gonna want the other sweet spot, which is just kind of above the knuckles in this puffy area of your hand. And that part will line up over the drum. What you want to avoid is hitting the wood directly on those knuckles. No sound comes from that and it injures your hand. You also do not want to come across the wood edge anywhere across the fingers here, because again, this is a delicate part of your hand and that will bruise your fingers. So the two sweet spots are just above or just below, but not far down. You don't want a lot of your hand in, because if your fingers reach too close to the center of the drum, you're not gonna get a distinction between your tones and your basses. You'll get too much bass in there. And these are just for the basic sounds. There are aesthetics where you can bring out a tone that has a little more bass in it on purpose. But for now, this is just getting your very first sounds. They should be very distinct and very clearly delineated, not mixed. That's for more advanced players. So as beginners, you want to have a distinct bass, a distinct tone, and a distinct slap. Okay, so all of those things with the slap, with the tone that I went over, fingers are together, palm is engaged and open, not relaxed and collapsed. Keep the palm open. Use your elbow to lift and raise. And on this one, you have to have a bounce of your wrist. And it's the arm that helps throw that wrist down and up. You never want to let the wrist drop below the level of your arm. So that's never going to get you a good sound on the djembe. You're always going to have a slight bend to your arm. Okay, so even when I come down on the djembe, my hand is going to be slightly bent like this, versus coming down and being flat and pushing my hand down, right? That's not going to get a good sound. So here is the tone. Everything is touching evenly at the same time. Like, this is now my drumstick. It's like a spatula that everything has to hit the drumstick at the same time. And I bounce back up. So again, that's your tone, fingers together. Now you're gonna keep the same position for the slap. For me, my hands are short, so my sweet spot is just underneath the knuckle, okay? It kind of grabs the edge of the drum like that. When I play, my palm is touching the ropes on the drum. I don't keep my palm up in the air because that causes my fingers to point down and it causes my wrist to strain. So I keep my palm touches the bottom. That's for the tone. Same thing for the slap. Now I let my fingers be relaxed. I don't strain them like this. I just relax them, okay? It's the same if my hand is dangling down here, I'm going for a walk, my fingers naturally hang like that. So I do that for the slap. And the slap, you are gonna wanna think of your fingers popping off from the drum very quickly, almost like a slingshot. Like imagine there's a rubber band pulling your fingers back, and as you release your arm and your hand, the slingshot lets go, and they fly forward, and the fingertips will pop on the drum skin. You do not control this, so it's not a grab of the fingertips onto the drum. And you can't do it without any other part of your hand touching the drum. That won't get a slap. So your fulcrum is your sweet spot, either just above or just below, is gonna make contact on the edge of the wood. And when you feel that contact, just pull your hand back. If your fingers are relaxed enough, they will create a little pop, a forward motion on the drum automatically without you doing anything. So here are some slaps. You have to be very quick with your snap of the wrist. Keep the angle. You don't even see my fingers touch the drum. That's how quickly they are. But I keep my palm engaged and I keep my fingers upright. They can have a little curve to them if you want, that's fine. But don't let them reach the drum at the same time as your palm, because then there's no snap. There's no release of the fingertips onto the drum skin. Okay, and remember that the vibration that you're creating from the drum skin is what's creating the sound. So you never leave your hand on the drum skin for any long period of time. Okay, you're always releasing very quickly. So now that you have an idea of how to get these sounds, let's do a couple basic exercises just so you can practice your muscle memory in going between the different ones. First thing is just go bass, tone, slap on your dominant hand, take a breath, and then do bass, tone, slap on the non-dominant hand. All the while you're thinking of the adjustments that you need to make between the sounds. Bass, no wrist, flat hand, solid, quick. Tone, you bring your hand back, your elbows come out a little bit, you point your index fingers towards the center. Fingers are together, controlled, thumb is out, wrist is slightly bent, and you throw the hand down onto the drum. And then for the slap, same place of the drum, same kind of movement, and you relax the fingers, okay? So here we go. Switch. 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 now that you have some idea of the two, you can practice on your own before continuing on the video. Now you're going to do the same sounds, but you're going to do them alternating hands for each note. So now you're going to engage both sides of your body. You're going to do the bass, bass, then tone, tone, then slap, slap, and then start again. Here we go. Again. 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 If you're comfortable, do it without putting a pause between the sets, like this. The idea is you're building muscle memory so that you don't have to look at your drum when you're playing, but that you feel how much you need to move your hands back to get that sweet spot on the side when you're going from a bass to a tone. So the next phase of the video, I'm gonna do some exercises that I do as my warm-ups in the classes so that you're familiar with these when you first take my class. We do eights, fours, twos, singles, and this gets your body to reinforce its consistency in getting sound. So what we do is we start with only tones and we'll do eight on each hand, back and forth, eight, 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 eight. And then I'll say go to fours, and then you switch when you get to your dominant hand side and do only four in each hand. And then I'll say twos. When we get to the twos, only two in each hand. The idea when we get to the twos is that you're trying to get faster and faster, mainly because in order to do fast rolls, you have to have a quick twitch of your arm and your wrist. You've got to be reacting quick. So practicing those double strokes will help you for later solo techniques when you get more advanced. So we're going to start with all tones, then we'll do all slaps. We don't do basses. That's too easy. So we just do it with tones and slaps. Okay? So eight on each side. Tones are fingers controlled. Okay? Keeping in mind all of the details. Here we go. Ready? Go. 'Keep your back straight, engage your core, shoulders should drop down. You want to pull your lat muscles so that your shoulders are down and back, and keep your shoulders kind of firm, but let your arms go as fast as they can. And the idea is learning to breathe at that pace. So letting go and then trying to keep your breath steady. Okay, so now we do the whole cycle again with only slaps. So starting with our 5, 6, 7, 8, and starting dominant hand for the eights. 5, 6, 7, 8. because by now you're usually sweating. We do three sets, and it's a coordination exercise where you're going to go from, you're going to do two notes back to back, but in a time signature that's like a waltz. So it's going to be a 1-2-3, 1-2-3, 1-2-3. And the first set, the first combination is going to be bass with a tone. Okay, so flat hand to fingers controlled to the tone. And you're gonna do that four times in your dominant hand and then automatically switch to the non-dominant hand, okay? And again, it's gonna be a 3-4 time signature, which means that 1-2-3, 1-2-3, 1-2-3, okay? So we'll start slowly with our dominant hand, bass tone, four times, and then switch four times, back and forth. Ready, go. So we'll do that and then we'll go faster. So here's a faster version of that. Ready, go. The same format with different combinations of sounds. So the next combination is bass slap. We'll start slow and then we'll speed up halfway through, starting with your dominant hand. Bass to the slap. So relax those fingers and make sure you get a nice snap of the wrist and keep the angle slightly engaged. Don't let your wrist push down and go flat. Here we go. Bass slap. Slowly. Ready. Go. The last combination for this format is tone slaps. Tone slaps, you do not change your position. You don't go from here to here. You don't go from there to there. Exactly the same position for your tones and your slaps. The only difference is you're going to go from fingers being controlled to fingers being relaxed. The motion looks the same, so I don't do a motion where I dip on one and I change my angle. It should look exactly the same. It should feel exactly the same when you move your body. Okay, the only difference really is fingers controlled, fingers relaxed. So we're going to do the slow and then we'll do fast tone slaps. Ready, go. Switch. Thank you. So again, reiterating that you're not going from controlled to stretched. You don't want to be tense when you go to the slap. So just keep your fingers together and then relax them, because relaxing them will automatically make them go apart. So together, relax, that's the change between tones and slaps. There's a few more exercises that we'll do in class, but those are the core ones. The other one that we work on is developing our roles. So when you come to class, we'll go over that in person. But for now, you can get started with these basic techniques that I've shown you, and reach out if you have any questions. Happy drumming!